How would you position yourself on a creative scale of 1 to 100? Low 40s, mid 60s, or a solid 100? Funny thing is, the number doesn't matter. Just be you, that's all we need. But it can be fun to do a little test, to see if my ideas can help you in any way. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, inspiring you to embrace the magic of making art. In my opinion, anyone, or everybody, is creative. Just start using your creativity. I just made this one, my number one. I painted a red square of 10 by 10 centimeters in the middle of a 20 by 20 centimeter piece of paper. Looks simple, right? Now, as a fun exercise, let's see in how many ways I can change the image. I use my finger to check if the paint is still wet. It alters the image. A minor change, but still a new version, my number two. I made 20 extra versions to play with. Not all perfect, but good enough for their purpose. First, I paint the square blue. Technically, I can change it in any color, but let's limit it to the three primary colors and black and white. So this new blue one represents option number 3 to 6. Now I change the shape of the square into a trapezium or trapezoid. It could also be a rectangle, a rhombus, or any of these other square family members. So, number 7 to 12. Over to number 13. It's going quickly like this. A question pops up in my mind. Is this what creativity is about, or is it just plain logical thinking? Let's go over to you. How do you define creativity? It's fun to write it down on paper and perhaps ponder over it the coming week, if you want to change it. I really recommend to press pause now to do so. Back again. I change number 13 to number 14. Here's my definition. Creativity is switching perspectives and making new connections. In a minute I will explain in more detail. I get help all the time. The only thing I have to do is ask and to be open to surprises. Like when this tractor passed me last week. Look at the metal poles. They all have an open rusty square at the bottom. Or even only two rusty lines. Here, number 15. Depending on how I presented painting to others, here, number 16, 17 and 18. Asking myself, what do I see, can bring me a red square. But when observing closer, in more detail, it brings me a red square painted in the center of a white squared piece of paper. Each of these words can bring me new ideas. Like by naming the white paper, I get a new element I can play with. Even more precise, it was unpainted white paper. Now it's painted yellow. Numbers 21 to 25 for the other primary colors and black and white. Remember the rusty squares? It can happen all day at any moment, like here, avocados for a salad. I noticed the change in color from the outside in. I put some fresh red paint on the square and paint from the inside out using titanium white. Not that brilliant, but the close-up, when dry, shows nuances. Another option is perhaps an optical illusionary 3D version of a square, representing all tints, tones or shades I can create. Let's say number 27 to 29. Remember the close observation? I can change the paper size to twice as wide. What brings me to the location question for the square? I put one on the right side, my number 30. 31 with a square on the left side, number 32 having one in the middle. When I think of squares, checkers comes to mind. And how about only partly on the paper? Or in a different angle? It always helps me to approach a complex situation or a concept like creativity by trying to visualize a system behind it. Painting or drawing it can show flaws or blank spots in my ideas. A row of dots, little freehand squares, as options, choices, possibilities. The logical version of going from A to B is a straight line by connecting all the dots. Now let's zoom in on this one called shape. Like the square I use in the video and the options I already talked about. like the family of squares, a circle representing the rest of the whole geometric family. I could also go the other way, irregular forms like a blob, a recognizable form like a plants or trees, animals like this, fish or whatever. Creativity can be about variation, like all these squares. And this exercise shows me again how many versions I can make. I even feel proud about it, although the number is irrelevant. The real relevance is getting a glimpse of the number of possibilities. Way more than I guessed there would be. It gives me peace of mind, knowing I have more options. Always. Also relevant is finding or seeing the system behind it all. Creativity is also about logic. Next to luck, soft skills. And don't forget experience. Lots of it. Each step on this horizontal row is a world in itself, like this one, color, or this one, size. So when going from A to B, I can go like this, or like this, or never go to B at all, or even start at B. No matter what I create, it's the fun of the journey, the fun of the process that matters. Or is it mainly about having fun? Now it's up to you. What can you think of for number 50? Will this do? Or how about honoring the stencil for helping me make this video? In case you like to look at artwork and the possible process behind it, just click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.